Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how I created this cool animation effect using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. This is a clean slate here and this is my index.html file, my style.scss file and my custom script file. My index file also includes font awesome CDN here and jQuery library here. Okay, let's get started now. First let's add a div with a container class. And inside that we'll add a div with a class of icon, and inside this we'll add font awesome icons. Hurt. Okay, you can see the icon is present here. We'll add a couple of data attributes here, data-clones equal to 20. So this is used to control the number of clones. I'll show where this can be used in the JavaScript here. And data-radius set to 600. Okay. Let's go to style.scss. So inside this I'm picking a color ED217C, some pink color. So inside the body I'm writing the background color as lighten, icon 35%. Okay, lighten is a SAS function which gives the light color of the color we mentioned here based on this percentage. Okay, we'll target the container class, we'll set its position to fixed, top 0, bottom 0, left 0, right 0, and we'll set the margin to auto. We'll make it display as flex. We'll justify the content to the center and we'll align the items to center again. Click on save. You can see the icon is in the middle of the page. Okay, let's target the icon. We'll set its position to relative. We'll display as inline block. We'll set its font size to 50 pixel and set its height to 60 pixel and also width to 60 pixels. We'll text align to center and we'll set its line height to 1.4 and we'll set the color of the font color to icon. That is the color we specified on top here, pink color. Okay, we'll set the text shadow 0 pixel, 0 pixel, 2 pixel, RGBA 0, 0, 0, 0.4 and colon hover. So when we hover on the icon there, we want the point cursor to be a pointer. So this is it. Now we'll target the clones class. This is appended using JavaScript. For now we'll just style the element. Later we can see, we can add these elements with JavaScript. Okay, so set its height to inherit, that is inheriting the parent class, and its width to inherit again, and we'll set its position to absolute and left to 0 and right to 0, top to 0 and bottom to 0, and set its margin to auto. We'll display these elements as inline block again and we'll set line height to inherit. And we'll set the text shadow 0 pixel, 0 pixel, 10 pixel, RGBA, 0, 0, 0, 0.4. Okay, we'll set its z-index to -1, and we'll set the pointer events to none. Okay, I'll show you what is the use of this clones class. We'll quickly jump into the script file. First, document.ready. I'm using jQuery for this reason. I'm writing document.ready here. So inside this document.ready, what we're going to do is we'll target the icon class, and we'll make a click handler. On click of this icon, we want this function to execute. So var clones equal to, what we are going to do is we'll target this dot attr, which gives the attribute data hyphen clones. So whatever clones we specified in the HTML, data hyphen clones, we can get them using the attr, that is attribute. Okay, and var radius equal to dollar this dot attr data hyphen radius. Okay, now what we want is when we click on this element, we want to generate the number of clones we specified here and append to this icon class, icon div. Okay, so to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm using a for loop here. For let I is equal to 0 and I less than clones I plus plus, this dot append. So what we are going to do, we are going to append is this dot find FA colon first, that is the font awesome icon's first element. So we want to clone that element, and we'll add a class of clones to that. So we'll click save here, and we'll check it out. Let me inspect the element. So the icon div has only one font awesome element here, font awesome icon. When I click on this, it seems there is an issue. Let me check here. Icon on click function clones data hyphen clones data hyphen radius for let I is equal to 0, I less than clones I plus plus, this dot append, this dot find fa colon first, sorry, dot fa colon first. Now let's try again. And when I click on this, you can see the number of clones are appeared here. So I specified the number as 20. That is the reason we are having a 20 clones here. Okay. Now next target is we need to animate these clones. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'll add a set timeout function here. So that is the end of for loop. I'm using set timeout function. So it takes a function and time. Okay, say after 1 millisecond. So let me write a comment here. Set timeout. Now what we are going to do is we'll target the clones. So dollar dot clones dot to array. So I want each and every element individually to animate. That is the reason I'm using two array. I'm converting all the clones into an array using a for each, and inside the for each we have a function which takes a clone and index of that element. Okay, this clone is an individual element of clones. Okay, targeting the clone, so that is each individual clone, and we'll change the animate property here dot animate. So what we are going to animate is we'll set the top to 0 and left to 0, right to 0 and bottom to 0. So initially we'll set all the top, left, right, bottom to 0. Then we will chain another animate function here. And we'll execute it index into 50. That is the index from here and into 50. So first one will have 1 into 50 and second one will have 2 into 50. That is the random animation timing we can give here. Okay, so we'll set the top. Before setting the top, first let's write one function here to generate a random number. So coming out of this, where get random integer equal to, it takes a function min and max, by the way I am using ES6 syntax. So what we will return is math.floor, math.random into max minus min plus 1 plus min. That is, if we specify 10 and 20, we will get a random number between 10 to 20. Okay, that is the use of this function, get random integer. Okay, now for the top we are going to use get random integer. So we got the minus radius here, so we will set the radius to minus radius to plus radius, and similarly bottom to get random integer, and similarly I am cloning these two and setting the right and left properties to some random value. Okay, and after finishing this we'll chain one more animate function and we'll set back the top, bottom, left and right to zeros again. Okay, and similarly the time here is index into 50, and after completion of this we can run a function here. So inside this function what we are going to do is this dot remove, that is we are removing the clones we created using JavaScript. Okay, let's give a try. So when I click on this, you can see the clones jump again, they come back to the element here. Okay, so we can also add an opacity property here, can set it to 0.5. so when I click on this, okay, hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Please do watch other videos on my channel. Take care.